broken my heart so many times I stopped keeping track. Talk myself in. Oh, yeah.
And again, this has some ageability. I mean, you it could does. Certainly lay that down
yeah.
for some time.
You absolutely that, could.
And,
yeah.
and it would just get a little softer and
yep.
and
yeah, these will hold really well. So you yeah. you don't have to be afraid to, you know, if you want to buy a case, you can always set some down and revisit
yeah.
them in a
or
few more
Or just buy
years.
Two cases. You drink that one now, and then a couple years down the road,
yeah.
right?
Pull some more corks. Yeah, that's it.
Go. So $60, another great, it's still a great value based on what it took to make. And now tell me where the fruit, and that's Napa, is that
Yeah, that's Napa. Hillside? It's actually, it is. It's Hillside. It's up in the hills, out past Lake Hennessy, so eastern hills of
okay.
Napa. You go out like you're going up to Chapelet, Colgan, Bryant, up in the hills up there, and just past that lake, up one of the little side canyons, is a very rocky little section that I buy this Syrah from, and it's just an expression of that one little place. So
nice,
distinct
nice. Well,
site.
We like any of those
yeah.
rocky soils. That's
yeah.
really good for that fruit.
Yeah, they
do
are.
Do you get to do you get any kind of say on the way that it's grown? I mean, do you get a little input?
Yes,
they,
I do.
You know,
absolutely. They
oftentimes
really
they give you what you got. You know
I know.
I mean?
No, it's not like that.
You know.
No, this is really custom farm for us. So I contract the fruit that I want, and then I
nice.
Definitely have input on how it's grown. And they have a wonderful vineyard manager there too, but which is so nice. He asks me, what do you want? What are you interested in? And
right.
all of that. And so I do have some good input on that. And we walk the vineyard often together and just see how it's doing through the season. And then as we get closer to crush too, then it's, you know, a lot more often I'm out there just to, checking to get it just right when we pick.
Well, and that's really important because, you know, if you don't get some of that say,
yeah,
you know, it changes the fruit
oh,
dramatically.
Yeah. Oh, that's
you know,
true.
You've got to drop some fruit. It's just part of the process.
Yeah.
You want to cry when you see it laying on the ground.
I know. No.
But it's the difference between
well,
a
it's
good
the
wine
between,
and a fabulous wine.
Yeah, that's right.
That's,
when you want to make something really special, I'm interested in making great wine. I'm interested in making the best wine, not just making wine. You know, it really elevates it to really more of an art form. And that's the little segment of the market that I'm interested in, which is really
yeah.
fun.
Yeah. Well, that really shows.
Thanks.
So next is Barrett Vineyard. So
yes.
this is obviously...
what a coincidence with the name,
yeah,
huh?
Yeah, how weird is that?
Who knew?
Well, you know, we went over to Schramsberg, Angie and I and my son Kevin, and oh no, well, it was Andrew, that's right, it was Andrew, what was I thinking? And we pulled in front of you.
Oh,
and
really?
you were heading toward Calistoga. I
oh.
turned at the garage.
Oh, no kidding.
I was right there.
Okay.
Yeah. yeah
oh.
Yeah.
Passion,
we
I never saw you.
No,
oh.
No. We tried to wave you down, but, you know, because we're celebrity, you know, run that celebrity. There she is.
Yeah, thanks.
So this is Barrett Vineyard.
Yeah, this is from our little Barrett Vineyards, and we're at the foot of Mount St. Helena. So this section of our vineyard is only a small 2-acre little, very rocky
wow.
piece, and it's really steep. Some of it's terraced, and it's really a kind of a unique little spot, I think. So the character of that comes through, you get some of the soil characteristic coming through there, a little more minerally and really layered and dense, which is a little different from the other, the straight Napa Valley one. Just two different vineyard sources. They're both Napa, but this one is
wow.
very, also very site specific.
Very different in the nose.
Yeah,
right out of the
very different in the nose. Very textural also when we taste it. I love the palate feel of this wine. It's
mm-hmm.
so... unique. So, mm-hmm. yeah, I really had to bottle it separate. I originally thought when we had this little piece, I might blend it into the Napa, but they're so different. I really had
yeah,
to
no, I think
have it be a
I
separate
think,
bottling.
I think-